This is too. That's all right. Perfect height. But make sure you put this up for Sheikh Haroon. Just say go. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala Rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in amma ba'd. All praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we send our greetings and salutations to our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear brothers and sisters, a very warm welcome to you all to the oldest mosque in Britain. This masjid was established by Sheikh Abdullah Kulliam in 1887, 134 years ago, where there was no masjid in this country. And this Englishman converted to Islam after visiting Morocco in 1887. The masjid was closed in 1908 for some reasons, but alhamdulillah, with the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and your support, we were able to reopen the masjid in June 2014. Before I go any further, I'd like to ask Brother Mohammed to go with the collection bucket to do the collection for the masjid. So if Brother Izzaz, if you could take the bucket and let Mohammed carry on with the machine, that would be helpful, inshallah. So Brother Mohammed has got the card machine. If anyone wishes to pay on the card, please feel free to do so. And again, after the Jummah prayer, he will have the card in two of the exits that you leave the masjid, you can pay by card on your exit as well. Jazakumullah khair. Please donate generously. What you're donating now, my brothers and sisters, is solely for yourself. So time does run out before you know, and we never know how long we will stay in this world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. So while you have the opportunity, give what you can for the sake of Allah, and that is an investment in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So please do your very best. Just a couple of few announcements. First thing is to say the clock will be changing. The British clock will be changing this Saturday about 1 o'clock in the morning. So next Friday, the Jummah khutbah will start at 1 o'clock. So as the clock goes back, so on Sunday, you will have to, the clock goes back. So make sure you're aware of that. And the Jummah khutbah will start at 1 o'clock, and the Salah, the Jamaat will be at 1:30. Can I ask everybody to come before 1 o'clock so that you can listen to the khutbah? About the car parking issues, they make sure everyone parks in the car park in the opposite and on the side of our building. Do not park at the back or anywhere else. You'll end up with tickets. And you may, you know, the neighbors are complaining that we are parking on their forecourts, which is not right. And they're having a big meeting about that. So please do not park at the back of the building at all. Couple of other announcements is that we have lost one of our dearest brother Yasin Kokar. We did his janaza on Tuesday of this week. He was the founding member of Penny Lane Masjid. He was also a trustee of Al Rahma Mosque way back. And sadly, he passed away on Tuesday. Please make dua for this brother who has actually worked very hard for the deen, for the ummah, and for the community. A very pious man, and it is very sad to see one of these pillars of our community go. At the same time, as from my hometown of Coventry, one of my auntie passed away, and her janaza is as I speak today. Please make dua for those deceased, and for all the loved ones who are no longer with us. Inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive their shortcomings and place them the highest place in Jannah. Ameen. Our classes, as usual, we have ladies' coffee morning class on Monday. Tuesday, we have the ladies' Quran. Can you believe it? This is a free course, a sister, qualified sister, teaching our sisters Quran adults. Every Tuesday on from 9:30 till 11:30. And we only have about two or three sisters. So please, sisters, if you are listening to me, you have a professional teacher teaching you Quran, Tajweed, and so on. Every Tuesday, 9:30 till 11:30, make use of that. And this coming Tuesday, there will be no karate classes as Sheikh Wadda, the teacher, is on leave. He's on holiday. So no karate classes on Tuesday. It will restart again on Thursday from 6 till 8 p.m. We do have the Wednesday 9:30 till 11, the ladies' exercise classes. Please make sure you attend to that. And of course, in the evening, we have 6 till 8, the children's madrasa, the Arabic and the Quranic classes. And Thursday, of course, I just said that karate classes 6 till 8. On Friday morning, we have knitting classes for sisters who wish to learn knitting. It's very important. At least you know how to do your buttons. I mean, I have to pay a tailor to get a button done because my wife doesn't know how to do them. So shame, shame on her. On Saturdays, we have the English ladies' classes from 10 till 2 p.m. Please make sure you attend that. And of course, Sunday, we have the children's madrasa again from 12 till 2 p.m. So inshallah, with all these things, and of course, you've probably seen a blue leaflet which says learn Arabic language. We have a professional Arabic teacher who will be teaching you Arabic language classes. We are waiting for the numbers. So if you're one of those who would like to learn Arabic as your second language, please contact us immediately and we will start the class as soon as we have the numbers. Men's English classes, I still don't have enough men to run the classes. I'm assuming everybody here can speak fluent English as I am doing. But if you don't, please contact us. Jazakumullah khairan for listening to me. Please stay tuned on our social media program. Go to Abdullah Kulliam Society, like it, share it. Go to the YouTube channel and subscribe it in the Q Media and press the bell button. That will remind you when we come on the air every time. Jazakumullah khair. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us all safe and well. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلله فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا سبحانك يا مولانا لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك فلك الحمد حتى ترضى ولك الحمد إذا رضيت ولك الحمد قبل الرضا ولك الحمد بعد الرضا. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، شهادة نرجو بها النجاة يوم اللقاء، عليها نحيا وعليها نموت وعليها نبعث إن شاء الله. وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا وقرة عيوننا محمداً عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه وخليله، خير نبي أرسله، أرسله الله بالحق بشيراً ونذيراً وداعياً إلى الله بإذنه وسراجاً منيراً، فصلوات الله وسلامه عليه كلما ذكره الذاكرون وكلما غفل عن ذكره الغافلون. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وعلى أصحابه الغر المحجلين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. أما بعد، فأوصيكم أيها المؤمنون، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله. اتقوا الله في السر والعلن. O believers, on this blessed day of Jumu'ah, always be conscious of Allah in everything that you do and every moment that you are. Remember that you have a Lord who watches over you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every single moment, be conscious of the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu attaqu allaha haqqa tuqatih wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. All those who have believed, be conscious of Allah as He truly deserves, and only die as Muslims. Only die as Muslims. Only die as Muslims. Fa ya ibadallah, O slaves of Allah, in every moment, treasure the gift of Islam and Iman and Ihsan that you have. Treasure the gift that you receive from your Lord, even though you have no rights over it. You don't deserve it. There's no entitlement for Iman. There's nothing. Yet your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to you. Whether you're born with it, whether you found it, it's your Lord who gave it to you. Alhamdulillah alladhi hadana lihada. Wa ma kunna linahtadiya lawla an hadana Allah. Praise be to the one who guided us to this, and had it not been for him, we would never have been guided. فَأَحْمَدُ اللَّهَ وَأَشْكُرُهُ. Thank your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala for every gift that He subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. And as we fulfill the obligation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَاسْعُوا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, when He said, rush and come early to ذِكْرَ اللَّهِ, to the خُطْبَةِ الْجُمُعَةِ, before we start, we remind you all, turn your phones off and turn your minds off and connect it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let there be no talking. Let there be no salams. Let there be no checking, no phones. These moments with your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dhikr Allah. Fas'au ila dhikri Allahi wa dharu al-bay'a. Just a few moments. Give it up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A few moments. Those who come, especially those who come later, and they come and they sit, and they sit against the wall. Ka'annahum khushubun musannada. Sitting against the wall, and all they're doing is checking the phones, checking their Twitter, checking their WhatsApp, checking whatever. But at these moments they are ma'allah, dhikr Allah, moments with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wasted all the blessings of Jumu'ah. وَمَنْ لَغَى فَلَا جُمُعَةَ لَهُ وَمَنْ لَغَى فَلَا جُمُعَةَ لَهُ. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, anybody during the Jumu'ah, khutbatul Jumu'ah, he does something that has no purpose, has no Jumu'ah. He has no Jumu'ah. So don't lose the reward of whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives to us. لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us. He's the gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed the believers when He sent a rasul, a messenger. لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا. And this gift was spoken of by Imam al-Busayri in his famous Al-Burda al-Sharifa. Imam al-Busayri, he commented upon this by saying, ومن هو الآية الكبرى لمعتبر ومن هو النعمة العظمى لمغتنم. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, رسولنا, نبينا, our messenger, our prophet, the one that we're honored to be part of his ummah. It was said about him that he is الآية الكبرى. He is the greatest sign لمعتبر, for those who think. And he is a نعمة العظمى. He is the greatest gift. He is the greatest blessings لمغتنم, for those who receive, for those who take. Let's not forget, as week after week after week, we share something and we try and experience something of حب الرسول, this love of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let's not forget his maqam with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his rank with his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, who himself told us, لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا الْمِنَّةُ الْعُظْمَى sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And before sharing some particular guidance that we can take from Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just to read a hadith, mawquf, Sayyidina Ali, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. And this is recorded by Ibn Kathir in his tafsir. In tafsir of al-ayah, الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الرَّسُولَ النَّبِيَّ الْأُمِّ. Ibn Kathir, he relates, and he relates this from the Musnad Imam Ahmed. عن علي رضي الله عنه أرضاه قال إذا سمعتم عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حديثا فظنوا به الذي هو أهدى والذي هو أهنى والذي هو أتقى. إذا سمعتم عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حديثا فظنوا به الذي هو أهدى والذي هو أهنى والذي هو أتقى. Whenever, this is Sayyidina Ali, and also reports the same from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. أخرجه الأحمد, أخرجه أحمد في مسنده. And Ibn Kathir, he mentions in his tafsir. Whenever you hear a hadith, anything said about Rasulullah, anything said about him, don't try and bring him down. Raise him. Don't try and bring him down. Don't be fooled and misguided by saying, إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. Don't stop there. Remember, يُوحَى إِلَيَّ. أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. Don't stop there. I'm a man like you, yes. But I'm not like you. Why? يُوحَى إِلَيَّ. Revelation comes to me. You're going to start saying, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the human being like me and you. Bismillah, where's the Qur'an that comes down to you? Where's Jibreel عليه السلام to you? Nowhere. Nowhere. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's beyond. So Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu, who knew him better than you and I can ever, ever, ever know him. Ever know him. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he knew Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What are they both telling us? Whenever you hear anything from Rasulullah, then in your mind, imagine that he's more guided than this. فَظُنُّوا بِهِ الَّذِي هُوَ أَهْدَى. Don't think he's like you and I. He's more than you and I. And whatever you hear from Rasulullah, whatever you hear about him, فَظُنُّوا بِهِ الَّذِي هُوَ أَهْدَى. More guided. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is more. وَالَّذِي هُوَ أَهْنَى. He's more amazing. وَالَّذِي هُوَ أَتْقَى. Whatever you can imagine of a Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, your prophet and his worship, he's more than whatever you can imagine. Don't think you're doing a favor to your faith so that you don't fall into shirk by thinking I'm going too far with him. فَظُنُّوا بِهِ الَّذِي هُوَ أَهْدَى وَالَّذِي هُوَ أَهْنَى وَالَّذِي هُوَ أَتْقَى. Think he's greater. Think of him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he's greater than whatever you and I can ever imagine. And we've just been given a glimpse into the one that Allah subhanahu wa created in the most perfect manner, the perfect jewel sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The perfect gem, the perfect jewel, the perfect gem that was sent to you and I so that we may receive our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. He connected us to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in your heart, instead of saying, what's the point of talking about how he smelt, how he walked, how he dressed, how he kept his hair, how he did his ring, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like, what's that to you and I? What worship am I going to do from this? Don't think that way. ظنوا به الذي هو أهدى والذي هو أهنى والذي هو أتقى. Put in your mind, he's more than anything. He's more than anything. Instead of looking at Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with your intellect, think about him with your heart. Because your relationship with Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after you've believed him with him, in him in your mind, is now an affair of the heart. All of seerah, all of shama'il, all of khasa'is, all the life story of al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the descriptions of him, the miracles, qissatu hub. It's a love story. It's a love story. Yes, we believe in him. Yes, we follow him. Now fall in love with him. And how are you going to do that? Don't bring him down. Raise him higher so you get raised higher. Raise him higher in your mind so you get raised higher. As an example, this is hub. This is an affair of love. This is an affair of love. As an example, an Anasin radiallahu anhu arda. فيما أخرجه الترمذي. A report that comes from Imam al-Tirmidhi. عن أنس رضي الله عنه أرضاه رأيت شعر رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم مخضوبا. أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه. And he was a true lover. He was a true lover. He understood al-Habib صلى الله عليه وسلم. He's the one that who said when the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم entered into Mecca, into Medina, Anara kullu shay. Anara kullu shay. Medina became munawwara. Al-Medina al-munawwara. Bil-munawwir sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said the city then became illuminated. And when he died and he left this world, adlama kullu shay. Anas ibn Malik Rukman said, everything became dark. Why? Why? Because his love sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had gone. He'd fallen in love with him. This is the same Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu on his deathbed. As he's dying, he tells him, put a hair of the Prophet in my eye. That's a qissat hub. That's a lover of the messenger. And he said, when I see him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I will say, khuwaydimak ya Rasulallah. He said, I will say to him, your little servant, O messenger of Allah. These are people who fell in love with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They weren't saying, how did he pray? And they said that. But everything about al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So now, Anas ibn Malik radhiallahu anhu is even describing the very hair of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, I saw the hair of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, makhduba, dyed, colored, dyed. So don't anybody say, the hair of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not important. Don't anybody say that. If you say that, you said that with your mind. But the one who connects with his heart, say every piece and part of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is azim, kana fakhman, mufakhama. Everything about him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is great. And so then Imam al-Tirmidhi, he then tells us, qala hammad, wa akhbarana abdullah ibn muhammad ibn aqil, qala ra'aytu sha'ra rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam inda anas ibn malik makhduba. One of those who came after the tabi'een, he said, I saw with Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, the hair of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He kept it. Why would he keep it? What's the hair got to do with anything? Qissat hub. They were in love. Likewise, Imam al-Tirmidhi relates to us. Haddathna Isa ibn Tahman. Qala akhraja ilayna Anas ibn Malik. Na'layn jardawayn lahuma qibalan. Faqala fahaddathani thabitun. ثابت البناني بعد عن أنس أنهما كانتا نعلتي أو نعلي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The very sandals or slippers that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم wore. What's it to you and I? Nothing. If you're thinking about him صلى الله عليه وسلم with your mind, nothing. But they thought with their heart when they came to him. قصة حب. It was a story of love. So Isa ibn Tahman, he said, Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu arda, he brought out two sandals that had no hair on them, no animal hair on them. And they had two straps on them. And he said, Isa ibn Tahman, Thabit al-Bunani, one of the main students of Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, said, Anas radiallahu, or he told him after that Anas radiallahu anhu said, Anas radiallahu anhu arda, he said, these were the two sandals of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What's the hair got to do with anything? What's the sandals got to do with anything? What's even the clothes? Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she brings out a rida, and she says, this was the rida, the shawl that the Prophet died in. Why is she keeping this? Why are they keeping it all? Qissat hub. They fell in love with Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They loved him more than you and I can ever imagine. So don't listen to anybody who comes to you and tells you the thawb is an importance. The sha'r of Rasulullah is an importance. Like the way he dressed is an importance. If he did it, it's important. There's maratib. There's definitely different levels. If he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he did it, it's important for those who fall in love with Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For those who have an intellectual, a rational relationship with him, and stop there, then there's nothing to that. There's nothing to that. But fall in love with Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and everything of his is important. And so today, what we want to further share is something of what they felt about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and particularly Ahlul Bayt Rasulullah, the household of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Hassan ibn Ali radiallahu anhu arda, the grandson of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on different occasions he went up to his uncle Hind ibn Abi Hala radiallahu anhu arda, and he asked him many different questions because he was young. Sayyidina Hassan was no older than 7 years of age when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left this world. But now that he's gone, he wants to know everything about him. Because that's his grandfather. And that's al-Rahmat al-Muhada. That's the gift of mercy. And that's al-Minnat al-Uzma. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his own grandfather, was the greatest of all gift. So when he comes into the presence of his uncle, Hind ibn Abi Hala, he asks him, describe to me, how did the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, look like so I can hold on to it? Shay'an ata'allaqu bih. Something I can hold on to. But he didn't stop there. Because the muhibbin, those who love Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they don't just look at the physical form. Yes, his face was more beautiful than any badr, any qamr, any shams. His face is more beautiful. Yes, the way he dressed was more beautiful than you and I can ever imagine. But they wanted more. So they asked him, describe to us how he was like at home. Describe to us how he was like when he went out. Describe to us how he behaved with people. How he dealt with people. Those who were harsh towards him. Those who were close to him. Describe to us everything about Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look at Sayyidina Al-Hasan. Sibt Rasulullah. Everything about Rasulullah, I need to know it. I need to know it. And that's the grandson who lived with him. You and I, we need to know everything about Rasulullah. So today, we're going to share one hadith. One hadith. Sayyidina Al-Hasan ibn Ali, radiallahu anhuma, قال, سألت خالي هند بن أبي هالة وكان وصافا قلت صف لي منطق رسول الله. منطق رسول الله, كلام رسول الله. هند بن أبي هالة, he's now being asked by his nephew, Hassan ibn Ali, describe to me how he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to speak. How did he used to talk? And the reason why I want to share this one today, so that our ta'alluq, so we have this connection. The lisan is the most dangerous thing that we have. The tongue is the most dangerous thing that we have. We can sit here and pray and read Qur'an. We can stand up and talk about Rasulullah. We can go to a class of tafsir al-Qur'an and hear the words of Allah being explained. And then the moment we leave, we start swearing. Yati sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ma kana fahashan. We start cursing. Wala la'anan. He never cursed. He never swore. He never backbited. He never lied. The purest of all tongues from the purest of all bodies and hearts. Purest of all tongues. It was impossible that anything could have passed his tongue except for the truth. It was impossible. Yet, we sit here We sit here, even during Khutbatul Jumu'ah, we'll talk, and waste everything with this lisan, with the tongue. We come to Jumu'ah to take the blessing of Jumu'ah, we lose it all because of the lisan, the tongue. The tongue is the most destructive of everything that we have. That's why the likes of Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala, said, Allah has placed the tongue inside of a cage, that's your mouth. Your eyes are open. You see haram, then you have to turn away. Your ears are open. Even if you turn away, you can't. You have to plug your ears. But your mouth, you have to make an effort to open it. You can't say, I didn't mean that. You can't say, I didn't mean that. You have to make an effort to open your mouth and let something come out of your mouth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caged it. You have two eyes, you have two ears, you have two hands, you have two feet, one tongue locked up as a prisoner inside your mouth. You're the prison guard. You need to open it and you need to let out whatever's inside of your heart. وَإِنَّمَا جُعِلَ اللِّسَانُ عَلَى الْفُؤَادِ دَلِيلًا. The tongue, it just indicates what's inside the heart. So when you go out of the masjid, think of MashaAllah, like, look at who I am. And then the next time you meet your mate, you start swearing and lying, backbiting. Like, that's your heart. That's your heart. That's the filth inside of your heart. The heart needs cleaning. كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم متواصل الأحزان دائم الفكرة. He was always in a state of worry. What about? Not about, can I pay my mortgage? Not about, is my house getting repossessed? Not about, am I going to lose my job? About you and I. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, always in a state of worry and concern. Why? He did not want anybody to enter into hellfire. فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعٌ نَفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ إِن لَمْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِهَذَا الْحَدِيثِ أَسَفًا. And this is one, ظُنُّوا بِهِ الَّذِي هُوَ أَهْدَى. Imagine him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is more than anything. Think about this. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, literally carries on his shoulders the weight of the world. And the world here is thaqalain. He's not just dealing with you and I. He's dealing with the world of the jinn as well. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is carrying the weight of all worlds on his shoulder. And he wants nobody to enter into hellfire. Yet, he's always smiling. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is always smiling. Think about yourself, you've got no problems except for your own problems. And those usually are not problems. They are, but usually they're not problems. The moment you've got a problem come into your life, you get depressed, you get down, you can't leave your home, you can't get out of your bed, you're all worried about everything. And when you're with people, you're difficult, you're a problem, because you got your stresses and your worries and your anxieties. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كان متواصل الأحزان دائم الفكرة, but at the same time, دائم البشر. Always has worries and concerns, but he's always smiling. He's always smiling, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ليست له راحة طويل السكت لا يتكلم في غير حاجة. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never had any rest. There was never a time. ليست له راحة. He had never had any time to rest and relax, because he was concerned for you and I. 1400 years ago, he prayed for you, that Allah grants you Jannah. He prayed for everyone in his ummah. لا يتكلم في غير حاجة. He never spoke unless he had to speak. The tongue. And where are people now? We're talking all the time that we have to stop ourselves from talking. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's quiet all the time that he has to make himself talk. He has to make himself talk. There's the first thing with the tongue. You want sunnah al-habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Stop talking. Stop talking. The more you talk, the more zallat. The more mistakes you'll make, the more likely you expose yourself to the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Stop talking. And only talk when you need to talk. That's al-habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then, وَيَتَكَلَّمُ بِجَوَامِعِ الْكَلِمِ. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ظُنُّ بِهِ الَّذِي هُوَ أَهْدَى. He's not like you and I. He's not like you and I. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, will say two words that you and I will speak an hour, 2 hours, 10 days, talking, just trying to explain. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. That's everything on your deen. That's it. Intentions. Everything you do is about intentions. Ulama, Salihun. They've written books after books after books explaining three words from the tongue of Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Innama al-a'malu bin-niyyat. Actions are only based on your intention. Don't say he's like you and I. You can't say three words and carry oceans of meaning. And in fact, this is one of those gifts that it said that not even other prophets had this. Not even other prophets had this gift. It was a gift of Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَظُنُّوا بِهِ الَّذِي هُوَ أَهْدَى وَالَّذِي هُوَ أَهْنَى وَالَّذِي هُوَ أَتْقَى. That's your Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's your beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's the tongue, the purest of all tongue. The tongue that will stand in front of its Lord and will ask his Lord, allow me to speak on behalf of my people. The tongue that will say, Ummati, Ummati, Ya Rab. The tongue that on that day will say, my people, O Lord. Even Adam, Noah, Ibrahim, Musa, Isa, Nafsi, Nafsi. At that point, the terror of hellfire, even the greatest of the Anbiya, Nafsi, Nafsi. The tongue can't move beyond myself. Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ummati, Ummati. The greatest of all tongues, the greatest of all. فَظُنُّوا بِهِ الَّذِي هُوَ أَهْدَى وَالَّذِي هُوَ أَهْنَى وَالَّذِي هُوَ أَتْقَى. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعنا وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم إنه سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه فيا فوز المستغفرين. الحمد لله, الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. أما بعد, كلامه فصل لا فضول ولا تقصير, ليس بالجاف ولا المهين, يعظم النعمة وإن دقت لا يذم منها شيئا. هذا كلام الحبيب صلى الله عليه وسلم. The beloved صلى الله عليه وسلم, his words were فصل, they were decisive, they were clear. Everything he conveyed was clear. لا فضول, nothing more than what was needed. ولا تقصير, nothing less than what was needed. ليس بالجافي, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was never harsh in how he spoke. ولا المهين, nor did he ever humiliate anybody in how he spoke. يعظم النعمة, he would magnify every blessing of Allah. وإن دقت, however small it may be. Think about the smallest of all. You go to the bathroom, you go to the toilet, you empty yourself out, you wash yourself. Something you don't talk to people about. What's he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say when he comes out? Alhamdulillah alladhi adhaba anni al-adha wa afani. Alhamdulillah. Gone to the toilet? Alhamdulillah. Yu'azzimu al-ni'ma. That's al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. غير أنه لم يكن يذم ذواقا ولا يمدحه. But he would never praise food, nor would he criticize food. If he liked it, alhamdulillah. If he didn't like it, he's not going to start saying it's hot, it's spicy, it's cold. Prophet ﷺ wasn't concerned about food. Prophet sallallahu, Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu arda's reports have said, anybody whose main concern is food is no better than what comes out when he's finished the food. He's no better than what comes out. You eat, you empty yourself out. He said, that's what you're like. Like the filth that comes out of you is the state of somebody's only concern is food. And then the description continues, and the final point from Sayyidina Hind, Sayyidina Hind ibn Abi Hala, جُلُّ ضَحِكِهِ التَّبَسُّمْ يَفْتَرُّ عَنْ مِثْلِ حَبِّ الْغَمَامِ. Imagine him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in front of you. Imagine him. You're sat there. You're one of those blessed souls who are able to gaze at him and able to hear his words directly. Most of the time he's smiling. He didn't laugh, except on the rarest occasions. Most of his laughing was smiling. And when he spoke, it was like pearls that were coming out of his mouth. It was like shining pearls that were coming out of his mouth. That's how they described him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Don't bring him down. Don't bring him down. Put him back where he is. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرًا. Allah raised him. Allah put him at the highest pedestal. Don't try and knock it down and bring him down, because you're only going to ruin yourself. You're only going to destroy yourself. You're only going to damage yourself. And always remember the words of Sayyidina Ali and Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, إِذَا سَمِعْتُمْ عَنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ حَدِيثًا فَظُنُّوا بِهِ الَّذِي هُوَ أَهْدَى وَالَّذِي هُوَ أَهْنَى وَالَّذِي هُوَ أَتْقَى. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وصل وسلم على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين وصل وسلم على سيدنا محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين وصل وسلم على سيدنا محمد حتى ترث الأرض ومن عليها وأنت خير الوارثين اللهم احشرنا في زمرة نبينا وتحت لواء حبيبنا اللهم أوردنا حوضه لا تحرمنا أجره واسقنا بيده الشريفة شربة ماء لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا وادخلنا الفردوس الأعلى معه برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اجعله أحب إلينا من والدينا وأولادنا والناس أجمعين ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استقيموا make sure your rows are straight leave no gaps between you الله أكبر سبحان الله إنك لا إله إلا أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده اللهم ربنا ولك الحمد حمدا كثيرا الله بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية؟ وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. اللهم الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers. Please make sure you leave your shoe bags as you leave the masjid. There is a black bin bag, bin box. Leave them in there, and we'll discard them for you. Just to say that when you are crossing the road, please make sure you cross at the traffic light. The weather is bad, and therefore you have children with you. Do not take a risk crossing the road in between. It's a very busy road, inshallah. Very important announcement. Next week, Jumu'ah Khutba will start at 1 o'clock. The clock will go back this Sunday, 1 hour back. But next Friday, until the end of March next year, it will be 1 o'clock Khutba and 1:30 is the Salah. So please make sure you come early. Just to say, those brothers who are here for the Nikah ceremony, please come to the main hall and remain here. Sheikh Haroon will do the nikah. So the guests who are here for the nikah ceremony, please stay in the big room upstairs where Sheikh Haroon done the khutbah from. So after the sunnah prayer, he will do the nikah. Jazakumullah khair. Oh, I've just been told if anyone else would like to stay for the nikah, you're more than welcome to stay. It's more barakah, isn't it? Bless the groom and the bride. Jazakumullah khair. And I did announce it that please make sure you come early for 1 o'clock next Friday. I get calls from 7 o'clock in the morning. What time is Jummah? What time is Jummah? And please remember, 1 o'clock, this will remain from next week until end of March 2022, when the clock changes again. Jazakumullah khair. I've said many activities. I've already announced it. I don't want to announce it again. Please make sure you pray for all the people who are not well. Please make sure you donate generously to the house of Allah and build up an investment in the hands of Allah. Jazakumullah khairan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us all safe and well. Amin. One last thing. We do have a vaccination center here tomorrow, every Saturday from 9 till 1 p.m. If you'd like to get vaccinated first, second, and the booster, please come along between 9 and 1 p.m.